channel. I hope you're all doing well. It's week 3 of my Seek, Gather and Create challenge, which I run over on Instagram with Tina, Mel and Laura. I'll pop all the details in the description below. This is an art scavenger hunt where we post 4 different items to find every Sunday of February this time round, and you find those items and create whatever you want with them. This time we had to find something green. So for that I have a page out of a magazine which has got predominantly greens on there, and also just a piece of paper that I've painted with green acrylic. We also needed to find an insect. Now I made this little textile moth, actually made a few of them. Here's the other one that I made. Playing around with some slow stitching, and I'm going to use one of those. Now I used little templates to make these. Now they take quite a long time, so the video would be far too long to show you how I made these, but if you are interested, drop me a comment, let me know. It's definitely something that I can potentially show you in some way in the future, but for the time being, we're going to use this little moth. We also needed some letters or typography. So I've got this sort of large text piece of paper from a book, and this stencil. I'm not sure if I'll use one or the other or both. And something sticky. So I have got my clear parcel tape for that. Thinking vaguely that I would do a parcel tape transfer or something. We'll see. So let's get cracking. I did have a little idea about where I wanted to go with this. I thought that the moth, being that it's not very, it's more 3D, it's going to work better on a standalone piece. So I'm going to do one of my weavings today. So I'm just going to take my green pieces of paper first of all and cut them into strips. It's a Wednesday here at the moment. It's very peaceful. My husband's gone out to work. He normally works from home, but he's out and about today. The kids are at school. I've just come back from having my hair cut, which I haven't had a proper haircut in so long, so it feels really good. Nice little treat for me. And now I've come back to a very quiet house, so I thought, why not just get on and work on my Seek, Gather, Create challenge for this week and get it filmed for you guys. Okay, that's my magazine. I'm not being very accurate with these strips, so they are very wonky. Ooh, that one was really wonky. I'll go with that and see. That should be enough, I think. So I'm going to start off with some strips on my desk. I'm going to mix and match them up. A bit of both. How big do I want it? Vaguely squarish. Thinking about my insect. We'll go with that. I'm just going to use a bit of masking tape to hold that down onto my desk. Making sure that they're not overlapping. I've been doing quite a lot of weaving again recently. I did a full day workshop, an in-person workshop last weekend in weaving. So it's something that I just I don't get tired of. Right, so now let's use some of these other strips to weave back and forth. Come on. This is just normal plain old cartridge paper that I've painted, so it's quite thin, but then the magazine page is quite thin as well, but it should be fine. I like that it's sort of trees and naturey, kind of goes with the other items this time. Come on. Keep going until we've got roughly a square, I think. Actually go and pick up my, normally my eldest daughter walks home from school, but she's broke her toe the other day, so I'm having to watch the time a little bit, so I don't want to be late in picking her up. I think I'm gonna, let's just check with them off. I think that's quite nice. Yes. So I'm going to just pause the video there. I'm going to sew this round on my sewing machine just off camera, and I will be back in a minute. Okay, I have sewn that round on the sewing machine. I actually put some fabric on the back, stitched that on just to make it a little bit stronger because it was really quite thin. I'm just going to trim that down now. Trim off my tails. Not being too careful, I quite like it slightly wonky. Okay, let's get rid of all those bits. Okay, and I am actually going to add to this base, I'm going to add a little bit of gesso. Just push that colour back a little. Just muting it a little. Not everywhere. I'm gonna make sure that I can still see some of the more vivid greens. A lighter patch there in the middle. Okay, let's give that a dry. Okay, that's dry. I'm going to grab my watercolours and add some contrasting colour, maybe a pink. Pink and green. I'm just going to pick the texture of the weaving up a little bit. Something like that. Maybe. Trying to create a little bit of an interesting background on it, really. I've got some De La Rowney neon pink. better. A little bit more on there. Just going to give it a little spray and move it about a bit. It's okay. Not in love with it yet. But we will carry on and see what happens. Okay, another dry and then we'll see. I mean, it's not the best background in the world, but it contrasts the colours with the moth very nicely. So we'll go with that for now. I'm gonna do a parcel tape transfer with my type and my something sticky. Move that out of the way. Where's the end? Come on, end. Oh, I can never find the end on these things. Ever. There we go. I'm not really worried about what it says. I just like the size of the text, so I'm just gonna put some down. Maybe I'll just put a wider strip, so overlapping it slightly, popping it down like that. Okay, just giving it a trim where I've got my tape down. Don't really want that white bit either. So let's have that, because that's a nice good strip. I'm going to grab a spoon and just burnish that so that the ink's well in, stuck into the glue from the tape. Alright, and then I'm going to wet down the back, give it a spray, make sure it's nice and wet, and I'm just going to hopefully then rub off that layer of paper leaving the text. Well, hopefully it works. My something sticky and my typography or letters done in one. It's working fine, it's coming off well. Just got to re-wet it every once in a while, it gets dry. Cloth to get rid of the little annoying little bits. Nearly there. Here we are, my text. I think I'm just going to give it another one last spray just to get those last tiny little bits off. You love this technique. It's so simple. Simple but effective. See if that's that's a bit better. Still a tiny bit of paper on there, but we're not fussy. That'll do. I'll bring my weaving back. Come back in focus. And my thought was just that I'm going to then start layering up my elements. So perhaps I want. Maybe just a couple of letters. Let's just rip those. I don't know if I want these on it at all yet. So I am just playing around then with where to put it, how to put it. Do I want my text over on the side? Do I want it more like that? Do I want my other, do I want two letters on so it's like that? I wish that you could actually tell me. That would be useful, wouldn't it? Quite like the text at the side, like that. So I'm going to stick that down. I'm going to use matte medium because I can then put a layer over the top and it will take away the shininess of that tape as well, which I'm not that keen on. So a layer down on my weaving, sticking it down. And then I'm going to put a layer over the top to take off the shine. Like that. Which, when it dries, will work. Oops, hang on, there is a knock at my door. I shall be back in a moment. Sorry, that was my postman. Whew, run down the stairs. Whew. Quite like the bee. I don't know why I like the bee, because he's not a bee, it's a moth, but I think I like that letter better for some reason. Weird. I might just try dyeing this a little. What should I use? What shall I use? Let's try a little bit of coffee, a little bit of gesso, maybe. Splash of pink. Splash of green. Let's bring some green back. Yeah, let's give it a dry. Okay, that bit's dry. Where's my moth gone? Quite like it. Still not something quite there about it. What does it need? Let's go with a little
bit of washi tape, maybe.
Indecisive
today.
Bit of black around the edges, maybe, to make it stand out a bit more. This is just black watercolor. I'm just not sure about the letter, I think. Is it better without? Maybe it's better without. Let me have a play again. With. Without. With, without. I'm thinking without, you know, after all that. It's just not working. But that I quite like. So what I'm going to do is stick down my moth. I'm going to use Fabri-Tac to glue that down. It'll come out. So we've got something green, something sticky, and letters and an insect. We've got all our elements. Yeah. I put a few little dots in. Little pink dots. Maybe grab my pencil. Scribbles in. I don't think it'll scribble over the top of that, maybe. Stick down, moth. Maybe a word. I'll come back. I'll just look for some words. So I found the words looking for light in the darkness, which suits me moth perfectly. And then I've just pulled out a few little scraps of material. So I've got this nice blue one with gold flecks, some green, and I'm thinking of just adding that up in the corner there. So I'm just going to quickly stitch that, I think, and then I think that's going to be done. I'll be back with you when it's done. So here is my piece for seekgathercreate week 3. An insect, something green, letters or typography, and something sticky. I'm quite pleased with that in the end. I hope you've enjoyed that. Thank you very much for joining me, and I'll see you again soon. Take care. Bye.